Welcome to this week's installment of Reading with Robin, your number one destination since 2002 for insightful author interviews and discussions on everything literary. And with no further introduction, your host, Robin Call.
Latest gorgeous novel, Surfside Sisters. Nancy is the New York Times bestselling author of over 30 novels. Oh my God, Nancy, including A Nantucket Wedding, Secrets in Summer, The Guest Cottage, beloved books. Your books just mean it's time to read. It's summer. I am thrilled to have you on the show. Welcome to Reading with Robin, Nancy Thayer.
Thank you, Robin. I'm delighted to be here.
Well, and a side note, people will know because we've posted so much. We had the absolute pleasure of hanging out with Nancy at the Nantucket Book Festival before the storm. We were
right.
Like the calm before the storm sitting.
Yes, you were.
What a crazy weather we had. And I interviewed Mary Alice Monroe, one of your summer sisters. So she sends her regards. You'll hear that in her interview.
Oh.
And
oh,
we
good.
Just were gushing over all of these amazing books. And Surfside Sisters is everything I love about reading. And we've got to talk about these two friends, these sisters. Can you believe how many books you've written?
I can't. For one thing, I think I'm older than anybody else who's writing. And when I started writing, well,
Nancy.
No, I mean not like the Bible, older than the Bible. But I mean what they call women's fiction. So when mm-hmm. I started writing, it was women's fiction, and now it's become beach books, which
yeah.
is sort of cool in a way because that lets people know they're going to enjoy the book and
yes.
not have to get serious and depressed, which you don't want to do
no.
in the summer. But
no,
I also
don't.
Like to sneak little things in there, and I think I have, and I think I am.
You have absolutely. You've snuck so much. There's a lot to talk about in this book, and I have many notes all over the place. The idea is that it's light, it's summer. There's always so much to talk about. So you did sneak in. What were some of the things that, I mean, I think I can guess some of the things that were snuck in, but what are some of the things that you snuck in?
Well, I think one of the things was, and I don't know if I ever used the word, was envy, which it's like my best talent. And I think that's probably because I grew up in Kansas
mm-hmm.
and I grew up in Wichita and I had a very nice family and I had a very good time, but I read so many books. I always wanted to be in England or in New England. And I'm finally here.
You are here.
Yeah.
Full-time island resident for, was it 34 years on Nantucket?
Yeah.
There,
yeah.
Yes, envy is a really big theme and balance between friendship and what women think about each other and about envy. So, yeah, we've got Isabel and we've got Keely and they're best friends. And you've also put an older brother in there, which is always delicious part of the novel. And they both have writing ambition. They're friends from when they're little. And there is envy as Bill's grown up with money and summer vacations and all of this. And Keely's had to work in the summer and she's got her island friends. And we watch as these two women grow older and there's, you know, a guy in common there. You've thrown in some really great stuff, but envy and also just what happens with Isabel and Keely's relationship is, you know, it's rather serious. I mean,
it is.
Yeah. Yes. And the fact that there's no Dunkin' Donuts on Nantucket is also snuck
there's
that
no
in.
There's no Dunkin' Donuts. There's no McDonald's. There's no Burger King.
It's, which is a beautiful place.
Yes, actually, I love Burger King. That's the first place I go when I
go.
Oh, no,
I meant it's a beautiful place because you don't have that stuff. That's so funny.
Well.
Right. Is there an idea of, like, when you're going off island, is it like, you know, when you come home from college and you go to your home and there's things you just can't wait to get, when you leave the island, is that it? Burger King is your beeline?
And in the summer, it's Dairy Queen.
Oh,
it's
Dairy Queen.
Dairy
yeah.
Queen. And my husband, too, we're like, it's like dogs salivating on the ferry as we
That's so
go off.
Funny. I
yeah.
love that's what you can't wait to get. And
right.
being on the island, the places that are just, you know, mom and pop and so, you know, unique places, to me that's such a treat. But I can imagine you do have Stop and Shop albeit,
that's,
you know,
it. That's what
gray
we got.
Shingles.
Yes.
Yeah, you
yeah.
do have that. They could stick a little Dunkin' Donut kiosk in yours. That's what we have here on the mainland. But
yes,
you don't want to
see
those cups littered about.
Probably not. No. There's a historic district commission law, or some kind of Nantucket law, that the big chains can't be over here.
Sure.
Although they allowed Ralph Lauren to be over here. And
wow.
I don't know why. Well, you know why.
Yes, you know why.
It, yeah.
You know why. It has something to do with Ralph and Lauren. So back to our story. Yeah, this is like, I feel like I'm right back on the deck having our drinks with you after we got off the ferry, except for I'm here and not there. So talk about Isabel and Keeley and what you were inspired about to develop their relationships in this story.
Okay. I think part of it has to do with the friendship and how the people that we like that we're close to, we always envy some little thing about them. And if we don't, then they're not, I don't know, it doesn't work as well. But the other thing I really wanted to write about was how these two girls had this dream of what they wanted to do when they grow up, and Keeley really wants to live in New York City. And in my life, I have not gone in one straight line from Wichita, Kansas to Nantucket. There have been lots of zigs and zags, and a lot of times when I thought, oh, I should be doing this, I shouldn't be doing that. And I think when people set their sights on something they want to do, they get disappointed if it doesn't happen within a year, that sort of thing.
Yeah.
And they feel maybe depressed that they didn't make it. So I liked writing about writers in here because I wanted other hopeful writers to realize that it's really, really hard work, and you can do something wonderful. You can write a wonderful book, and then you write your next book, and your editor says, oh, I'm not liking this so much,
which happens to Keeley. And also, and I'm on the phone with Nancy Thayer. We're talking about her brand-new, gorgeous summer novel. It's called Surfside Sisters. Don't miss it. I really loved it. I fell in love with the whole story. I enjoy your book so much, and this was just such a treat. And one of the things that I've talked about often with authors and when they come to Rhode Island is that very fact that when somebody will say, oh, my editor didn't like this new book, or we had a 3-book deal and they don't, I'm always like, really? You wrote this one and this one. How could they, I haven't even read the next one. How could they not love it? But sometimes it's not what they're expecting. And in this case, the feedback for Keeley is that maybe she's lost something because she's not on the island. She's not with her beloved island or whatever, whoever, without ever giving any spoilers away. So that is important for, you know, this was very much readers and writers certainly go hand in hand. And I think a lot of readers who do want to write will really appreciate the nuggets that you carefully placed on a shelf for somebody to pick up and go, oh, that's what, you know, it's like some really good inside writerly scoop, I thought.
Good.
Really
good.
Fun to read. That's what I meant.
But I have to say that somebody in the business said nobody wants to read about writers because they're boring.
Oh, that's so not true.
Well,
who said that?
I've met a lot of writers, so you
know. Oh, that
is,
that is so not true. That's why I started the whole Reading with Robin show. I think I was telling you, I think writers are the most fascinating people, and not just because they can eavesdrop like no one else, but that is, I think, writers and aspirations for writing and where stories come from, and a lot of what you shared in Surfside Sisters is fascinating. So I disagree.
Good.
Yes.
I will choose your decision.
There is the road not taken, or the path of least resistance, or whatever brings these women to where they are. But I think for Keeley, I mean, there's also a sense of family obligation, and, you know, things take a turn for her. So without giving too much away, like, how does she manage that and keep her dreams alive?
I think she's a very determined person. And I think in a way she's a lot like I was, because my first novel was published when I was 34.
Mm-hmm.
And that's, now that seems really old to me, but boy, I kept at it. And it was all I ever wanted to do.
If you enjoyed this clip, you'll love the entire interview. Just visit robincall.com and subscribe to RWR Salon, where you'll be able to listen to all full-length Reading with Robin podcasts. With your new subscription, you'll become a member of our Facebook page, where we give away tremendous books twice a week and post exclusive content. You'll also get an awesome book surprise for your birthday, and first dibs and discounts to your favorite Reading with Robin events. So, go to robincall.com and subscribe today to RWR Salon for the low introductory rate. We look forward to seeing you there.